Hibernate implements JPA standardized constructor expressions and SQL result set mappings to map the results of your queries, and it also supports proprietary result transformers. They provide a powerful and flexible way to map the result of your JPQL criteria and native SQL query to a specific object structure. This can be entity or DTO objects, Java util list or Java util map representations of each record, or a custom data structure. Hi, I'm Torben Janssen and I solve Java persistence problems for a living. In this video, I will show you a result transformer in Hibernate 4, 5, and 6. But before we start, if you are new here and you want to learn how to create your entity mappings with ease, build incredible efficient persistence layers with Hibernate and Spring, and all types of other Java persistence related stuff, subscribe and click the bell to get new videos every week. And also don't forget to like this video if you found it helpful. By doing so, you are helping me to reach more people with it. Result transformers were especially popular with Hibernate 4, but got deprecated in Hibernate 5. Unfortunately, Hibernate 5 doesn't provide an alternative for them. Due to that, it might look like result transformer would be removed in Hibernate 6. But that's not the case. Hibernate 6 will provide an improved version of result transformers based on two functional interfaces. Based on the current code in the Hibernate 6 repository, migrating your existing result transformer shouldn't be a big deal. Hibernate 4 and 5 include several built-in result transformer. In addition, you can provide your own implementations. But before we talk about the different result transformers, let me show you how to apply them to your query. You only need to provide an instance of your result transformer to the setResultTransformer method of Hibernate's query interface. If you are using JPA's Entity Manager and Query Interface, you need to unwrap them. If you unwrap the Entity Manager, you get the associated Hibernate session. If you unwrap JPA's Query Interface, you get Hibernate's Query Interface. I explained that in more detail in the Hibernate tip How to Access Hibernate APIs from JPA. You will find it here or in the video description below. Now let's get into the IDE and give that a try. Okay, let's take a look at some of the commonly used result transformers in Hibernate 4 and 5. JPA enables you to map each record in your query result to an unmanaged DTO object. You can define these mappings using a constructor expression in JPQL or constructor result annotation for native queries. Both of these options require you to add a constructor to your DTO class that sets all attributes. This can be problematic if your DTO class has a huge number of attributes. Hibernate's alias to bean result transformer provides another way based on the bean specification. It uses the default constructor of the DTO class to instantiate a new object. In the next step, Hibernate uses reflection to call a setter method for each aliased value in the query. That makes it a great fit for DTOs that are implemented as a standard Java class, but not as a record. In this example, the alias to bean result transformer uses the default constructor to instantiate a new person DTO object for each record returned by the query. In the next step, Hibernate calls the methods setPersonID, setFirstName, and setLastName with the values returned by the query. If you don't want to change the selected data and don't have a matching DTO class, you can use Hibernate's toList result transformer or alias to entity map result transformer. The toList result transformer maps the object array returned by your query with all its elements to a Java util list. The alias to entity map result transformer transforms the query result to a Java util map that contains all alias values of the result set. The alias of each value is used as the key of the map. Here you can see an example of the alias to entity map result transformer. You can use the toList result transformer in the same way. If you want to implement your own result transformer with Hibernate 4 or 5, you need to implement Hibernate's result transformer interface. That interface defines two methods, the transformTuple and the transformList methods. A common result transformer implementation implements the mapping of each record in the transformTuple method. The transformList method only returns the provided list of tuples. I use that approach in this code snippet to implement my own result transformer that maps each record to a person DTO object. When I describe the implementation of a custom result transformer implementation, I also mentioned one of the downsides of the current result transformer interface. It defines the transform tuple and transform list methods that both need to be implemented. Most applications implement only one of these two methods in a meaningful way. But because both methods are part of the interface definition, you can't use the result transformer as a functional interface in Lambda expressions. This will change in Hibernate 6. The Hibernate team has split the result transformer interface into the two functional interfaces, tuple transformer and result list transformer. Based on the result transformer implementations provided by Hibernate 4 and 5, this will be a small but nice improvement. We will need to wait and see how this will affect the existing result transformer implementations. Hibernate's result transformers provide various ways to map the result of your query to different data structures. They were commonly used in Hibernate 4, got deprecated in Hibernate 5, and will be replaced by a functional interface in Hibernate 6. Commonly used result transformers for Hibernate 4 and 5 are alias to bean result transformer, which instantiates and sets attributes on DTO objects based on the alias defined in the query, to list result transformer, which maps each record in the query result to a Java util list, alias to entity map result transformer, which maps the alias values of each record in the query result to a Java util list. You can also implement your own result transformer. In Hibernate 4 and 5, you need to implement the result transformer interface and handle the mapping of each result set record in the transform tuple method. Hibernate 6 splits the result transformer interface into functional interfaces, tuple transformer and result list transformer. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free member library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like cheat sheets and ebooks about JPA and Hibernate. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. And if you like today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!